In the name of God, the compassionate, the merciful, as Muslims, we always begin everything by invoking the name of God, our Lord, and in praising the Lord, we seek to draw closer to Him whom we praise even in times of distress. I offer you, Mr. President, in my own name and on behalf of the people of Kuwait, sincere congratulations on your election as President of the 45th session of the United Nations General Assembly. You represent, sir, a friendly country that has very close ties with Kuwait. Both our countries, as well as all other states, draw strength and effectiveness from the principles of justice and international law. We are confident, Mr. President, that under your stewardship, this assembly will be able to fulfill the aspirations of the international community at this point in time against an extremely complex international backdrop. I wish also to take this opportunity to pay tribute to your predecessor, General Garber, for the skill and prudence he demonstrated in addressing the concerns of the world community. At the same vein, special thanks and gratitude go to the Secretary General of the United Nations, His Excellency Mr. Javier Perez de Cuellar, for his persistent and outstanding efforts in the interest of international peace and security, as well as his keen interest in enhancing the role and effectiveness of the World Organization with a view to attaining the noble goals set by the Founding Fathers. Mr. President, since Liechtenstein has now joined the United Nations, it is our pleasure to extend a warm welcome to the new member and to wish its friendly people every success in their new status. We trust that Liechtenstein's presence here will promise multilateralism in all its aspects. Mr. President, I speak from this rostrum today as my peaceful country in passing through extremely harsh circumstances that have given rise to an unprecedented crisis in the history of the United Nations, which since its inception has sought to uplift justice on the basis of international law. Indeed, the Security Council has demonstrated that role by recently adopting series of firm resolutions in the face of naked and brutal aggression against the state of Kuwait. There is no doubt that the key role played by the Security Council is indeed a propitious one under the prevailing grave circumstances in Kuwait, and in fact in the world at large. It is our earnest hope that this role will continue to grow without waning and gain momentum without setback, in order to consolidate the rule of international law. Today, I bring to you the message of a peace-loving nation, a nation that has consistently worked for peace, a nation that reached out with a helpful hand to all those who truly needed help, a nation that sought mediation and reconciliation among adversaries. It is this very nation whose security and stability have been trampled upon as a result of its abiding belief in lofty principles inspired by our true Muslim faith and echoed in universal charters, pacts, and codes of morality. Today I plead before you the cause of a people whose land, until so recently, was a beacon for peaceful coexistence and genuine brotherhood among the family of nations, a people whose national territory was a gathering place for individuals from various peaceful nations who sought a decent and dignified life through constructive work. Some of these people have now been made homeless wanderers, living only on hope in their banishment, while others have become prisoners or fighters, refusing even at the risk of their own lives to surrender or yield to occupation with all its violence and brutality. Mr. President, the crisis of Kuwait is a manifold tragedy whose dire consequences affect not only Kuwaitis, but other peoples as well. In fact, it has jeopardized stability in the world, especially in the Gulf region.